bright duty. Every student matters.
Express the trigonometric ratios sine A, secant A, tan A in terms of cot A. Right. This we can do in numerous ways. Like we can directly use the identities. First, let us use the identity directly. We have to write in terms of cot A. Okay. What was the identity that is involving cot A? Cosecant square minus cot square A equal to 1. Right. And we have to write these ratios in terms of cot A. So, let's write cosecant square A equal to 1 plus cot square A. Right. This is the identity and this can be written as this also. Okay. So, what will be cosecant A? It will be nothing but 1 plus cot square A square root. Right. Now, we can write these identities. What will be sine A? Sine A will be 1 by square root of 1 plus cot square A. Right. And what will be cos A? I have to find secant A and tan A. So, let's first of all find tan A. Tan A is nothing but 1 by cot A. So, tan A can be written directly in form of cot A. Sin A I have already written in terms of cot A. What is left is secant A, right? So, what is secant A? Secant A can be written in this form by using, let us say, what is tan A? Tan A is sin A by cos A. If I bring this sin to the left hand side, it will become tan A upon sin A is equal to 1 by cos A, which is nothing but secant A. So, what I have to do is tan A by sin A. So, I can write secant A equal to tan A, which is 1 by cot A divided by sin A, which is 1 by square root of 1 plus cot square A, right? And simplifying this, I can write it as 1 plus cot square A divided by cot A. So, I have written all these three trigonometric ratios in terms of cot A, right? Another way to do it can be that you make a triangle, right? We have to write sin A, secant A, tan A in terms of cot A. Right. What I can do is I can make a triangle here. Right. Let's say this is angle A, this is B, this is C, and this is our right angle here. What is cot A? Cot A is adjacent by opposite side. Right. Why? You remember Soka Toa? What was tan? It was opposite by adjacent. So, what is cot? Cot is adjacent by opposite. What is adjacent side to angle A? This one. And divided by opposite, this side. So, if I take adjacent sides as cot A, the opposite side will be 1. Right? What I am doing is, what is cot of A? Cot of A is this side divided by this side. So, if I take this side as cot A, I'll have to take this side as 1, right? Now, if you can do, what is cot A? This is this divided by this, which is true, right? So, if I have taken these two sides like this, then I can, by Pythagoras theorem, say that this is nothing but 1 plus cot square A, right? Now, you can find sin A, cos A, secant A, anything. So, what is sin A? Sin A is nothing but opposite by hypotenuse, which is 1 upon square root of 1 plus cot square A. Right. What is secant? What is secant A? Secant is reciprocal of cos. Cos is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So, it is hypotenuse upon adjacent. And what is tan A? For tan A, you don't have to do anything because it is the reciprocal of cot A. Otherwise, it is opposite by adjacent. So, 1 by cot A. So, this is the second way to write these trigonometric ratios in terms of other trigonometric ratio, right? So, you can make this triangle or you can directly use the identities, right? Now, we have to write all other trigonometric ratios of angle A in terms of secant A, right? This is a similar question. So, I have given you two methods. Let us use the identity method one. Okay. So, what is the identity that involves secant A? We know secant square A minus tan square A is equal to 1. So, what will be tan square A? Secant square A minus 1 is equal to tan square A, right? So, I can write tan A is equal to square root of secant square A minus 1, right? So, I have written one trigonometric ratio, that is tan A, in terms of secant A, right? Cos A can be simply written as 1 by secant A, right? And what is sin A? We know that sin A by cos A is equal to tan A. So, sin A is equal to tan A into cos A, right? Because you will write tan A as sin A by cos A and cos A will get cancelled. So, sin A equal to sin A. So, this can be written as into 1 by secant A. So, you can write this identity as secant square A minus 1 divided by secant A. Okay. So, we have written sin A, cos A and tan A in terms of secant A. So, let us write cot A. Cot A is the reciprocal of tan A. So, it can be written as 1 by secant square A minus 1. Okay. So, which ratio is left now? We have written sin A, cos A, tan A, cot A, cosecant A is left, right? So, what is cosecant A? Cosecant A is nothing but reciprocal of sin A. So, we can write the reciprocal of this like this, secant A divided by square root of secant square A minus 1. So, I have written all other trigonometric ratios in terms of secant A, right? All other trigonometric ratios involving angle A in terms of secant A. You can use the second method also where you can make the triangle, right? And let's say this is angle A, angle B is 90 degrees and this is C, right? What is secant A? Cos A is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So, secant A is hypotenuse over adjacent side. So, if I consider hypotenuse as secant A, then adjacent side will be considered as 1, right? Once you take these, then you can apply Pythagoras theorem and write this side as secant square A minus 1 square root. Now, you can find all other trigonometric ratios here like sin A. Let me give you an example of sin A. Rest of the ratios you do yourself. Sin A is opposite by hypotenuse. So, what is opposite side? Secant square A minus 1 square root divided by secant A, right? Let's match the answer. Sin A is this, sin A is this, which is the same answer, right? So, you can use any of these methods and solve this question. Let's move to the next one. We need to evaluate sin square 63 degrees plus sin square 27 degrees divided by cos square 17 degrees plus cos square 73 degrees. For this question, I want you to tell me what is sin 63 degrees in terms of cos. If I write this as sin 90 degrees minus 27 degrees, then I can write cos 27 degrees. You remember the exercise on complementary angles? 63 degrees and 27 degrees are complementary to each other, right? So sine of 63 degrees can be written as cos of 27 degrees, right? Why I am doing this? Because I want to apply the identity in sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, right? So sine square 63 degree here can be written as cos square 27 degrees, and this can be written as it is sine square 27 degrees divided by, now look at these angles, 17 and 73, 17 degrees and 73 degrees. These are also complementary angles. Why are these complementary? Because their sum is equal to 90, right? So cos 17 can be written as cos 90 minus 73, hence it can be written as sine 73 degrees, right? So I'll write it as sine square 73 degrees plus cos square 73 degrees. Now this expression is exactly equal to this one. Why? Because I have just changed it into complementary angles, right? Like this. So now if you notice, sine square 27 plus cos square 27, angles are same, and sine square theta plus cos square theta type identity is there, so I can write it as 1. Similarly, in the denominator, sine square 73 degree plus cos square 73 degree can be written as 1. So it is nothing but equal to 1. Okay, so this is how you will evaluate these questions. Let's look at this question here. This says sine 25 cos 65, cos 25 sine 65. Now I'll look at angles 25 and 65. What is special about these angles? That their sum is equal to 90 degrees. 25 plus 65 is equal to 90. So these are complementary. Hence, sine can be converted into cos and cos can be converted into sine. So I can convert sine 25 into cos 65 or cos 25 into sine 65. Right? Because these are complementary. And how do we do that? I have already explained it so many times. So let's do it directly here. Sine 25 can be written as cos 65 degrees, and this as cos 65 plus cos 25 degrees as sine 65 degrees. Why I have written it like this? Because this will become an identity now. This is cos square 65 degrees and this is sine square 65 degrees. So now this is sine square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1, right? This conversion here is nothing but the conversion into complementary angles. Sine 25 can be written as sine 90 minus 65, hence it can be written as cos 65 degrees, right? That's why I have written sine 25 into cos 65 degrees. Right? I hope you have understood this question. Okay, choose the correct option, justify your choice. For the first question, the answer is B. If I take 9 as common, I can write it as secant square A minus tan square A. Right? And this is equal to 1. Why? Because this is an identity, that secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. So here secant square A minus tan square A is equal to 1. So 9 into 1 is equal to 9. Hence option B is the correct option. Okay, let's look at this part here. 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta, 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta. So let's solve it. Let me write the first part as it is, 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta, and let's change this in tan and sin theta in terms of tan. So it can be written as 1 by 1 plus tan theta minus cosecant theta, right? So I can write it like this, 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta, and this tan theta can be taken as LCM. So tan theta, here I can write tan theta plus 1 minus tan theta into cosecant theta. What is tan theta into cosecant theta? Cosecant is 1 by sine, and tan theta is sine by cos. So sine will get cancelled, 1 by cos is secant theta. So here I will get secant theta, right? Now if I multiply these two brackets here, 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta, 1 plus tan theta minus secant theta, I can write it as 1 plus tan theta whole square minus secant theta whole square by applying a plus b, a minus b is equal to a square minus b square divided by tan theta. So this can be written as 1 plus tan square theta plus 2 tan theta minus secant square theta divided by tan theta. Now you can clearly see that 1 plus tan square theta is nothing but secant square theta. Hence this part can be cancelled, right, by using the identity that 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. Hence you can write it as 2 tan theta divided by tan theta. Cancelling this tan theta, you can write it equal to 2. Hence the correct option is option C, right? Okay, let's look at part 3 here. It says secant A plus tan A equal to into 1 minus sin A, right? Equal to what? So let me manipulate this bracket here. Okay, secant A plus tan A. Secant A plus tan A can be written as 1 by cos A plus sin A by cos A. I'll write second bracket as it is. Okay, so this can be written as 1 plus sin A divided by cos A into 1 minus sin A. Now you can clearly see that the numerator will become 1 minus sin square A and denominator is cos A, and this is equal to cos square A by using the identity sin square A plus cos square A equal to 1. So this can be written as cos square A by cos A. Hence this cos A get cancelled and you will get cos A as your answer. So option is D, right? Okay. Otherwise there can be other manipulation also. This can be method 1, right? I have manipulated this bracket here, right? And left this bracket as it is. Other thing what I can do is I can manipulate this bracket and leave this bracket as it is. How? Let me tell you here. 1 minus sin A can be written as, if I multiply and divide it by cos A, what will happen is 1 minus sin A by cos A into cos A, right? So this can be written as 1 by cos A is nothing but secant A, sin A by cos A is nothing but tan A, right? Secant A minus tan A into cos A. So this bracket can be written as this expression. Now you can see that secant A minus tan A into secant A plus tan A is nothing but 1. So you get your answer as cos A. So this is the second method that you can use. In trigonometry, you can solve the questions in multiple ways, right? Let's move to this question now. 1 plus tan square A can be written as secant square A directly. 1 plus cot square A can be written as cosecant square A, right? Why? Because secant square A minus tan square A is equal to 1. So 1 plus tan square A is equal to secant square A, right? So I have written this directly as secant square A. 1 plus cot square A can be written directly as cosecant square A using the identity cosecant square A minus cot square A equal to 1. So if I change this secant square A into 1 by cos square A and this cosecant square A 1 by sin square A. So sin square A will become numerator and cos square A will become the denominator. And what is this? This is option D, tan square A. Sin square A by cos square A is nothing but tan square A. So option D is the correct option here. Otherwise, there is a simpler manipulation here which comes to my mind. 1 plus tan square A divided by, let's convert this cot square A into 1 by tan square A. So if I write this as 1 by tan square A, what will happen is I can write this as 1 by 1 plus 10 square a divided by 10 square a plus 1 divided by 10 square a. Now this will get cancelled and this 10 square a will come in numerator. So this is your answer. So there are multiple ways you can solve a particular problem in trigonometry. It depends on your intuition, right? What strikes at the time of examination. So you should be thoroughly practiced in trigonometry chapter so that you these methods click on the time. Okay. Prove the following identities where the angles involved are acute angles, okay, for which the expressions are defined. So we don't have to worry about the places where these ratios are not defined. It is already mentioned that the angles are acute angles, and we know at acute angles every trigonometric ratio is defined, right? So first thing we need to prove is cosecant theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to this here. I can do it by two ways. I can take left hand side and bring out the right hand side, make it equal to right hand side, right? Other way, I can take the right hand side and then bring the left hand side, bring it equal to left hand side, okay? So anyways, you can do. I will start with taking left hand side equal to cosecant theta minus cot theta equal to cot theta whole square. So let's write it in terms of sine and cos. 1 by sin theta minus cos theta by sin theta whole square, which can be written as 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by sin square theta. Now you should appreciate that sin square theta can be written as, so the numerator is 1 minus cos theta whole square and denominator can be written as 1 minus cos square theta, because sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Now the numerator is 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta and denominator is 1 minus cos theta into 1 plus cos theta. I am using this formula a minus b into a plus b frequently in this chapter, right? Because this formula should be very, very clear to you, right? I should not be explaining this formula again and again. This should be on your tips. So now what I can do is I can cancel this, right? And I've got my right hand side here. So this is my right hand side, hence proved. Okay, so this is how we will go about these questions. Okay, so let's look at the next one here. This says cos A by 1 plus sin A. Cos A by 1 plus sin A plus 1 plus sin A by cos A, and we need to convert it into 2 secant A. This is our right hand side. Sorry. So let's start this question. This says we need to convert it into 2 secant A, right? So what I can do here is there are multiple ways of doing this question, but let me start with method 1 here. I hope you are very, very comfortable with the expression secant A minus tan A is equal to 1 by secant A plus tan A, or we can also use secant A plus tan A equal to 1 by secant A minus tan A, right? So I need to convert this into secant A. So to bring it into this expression, let's divide numerator and denominator by cos A. So if I divide numerator by cos A, cos A by cos A will become 1. In denominator, 1 divided by cos A will give me secant A, right? And sin A divided by cos A will give me tan A. Understand? Plus this second expression, we don't have to change anything in this. Directly you can say 1 by cos A is secant A plus sin A by cos A is tan A, right? And this here can be converted like this, secant A minus tan A. So this can be written as secant a minus tan a plus secant a plus tan a. So tan a gets cancelled. It will give you 2 secant a, right, which is the right hand side. Okay, this is one of the methods of doing this question, right? You can devise your own methods, because trigonometry has multiple ways of solving a question, right? So let's move at next question. Okay, now this question again can be solved in multiple ways, but let me start with the left hand side, which is tan theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta. Okay, and I'll try to bring this into right hand side. So first thing what I can do is, let me try to make these denominators same. So what I can do here is tan theta by 1 minus 1 by tan theta plus cot theta divided by 1 minus tan theta. Now this tan theta can be taken as LCM, so I can write this as tan square theta divided by tan theta minus 1, so plus cot theta divided by 1 minus tan theta, right? What has happened is that I have taken this tan theta as LCM and then taken it to the numerator, so it becomes tan square theta, and this multiplied by this tan theta minus 1, right? So up to here it should be very, very clear. Now the denominator is same except the sign, okay? So let me change the sign here. I can write this as tan square theta divided by tan theta minus 1 minus cot theta divided by tan theta minus 1, right? Now the denominator is same, so I can write it as tan theta minus 1 tan square theta minus cot theta, can be written as 1 by tan theta, right? So the numerator becomes tan cube theta minus 1 divided by tan theta, and the denominator is as it is, tan theta minus 1. Okay, now the question become very, very simple. You should know the formula of a cube minus b cube. What is a cube minus b cube? These are the basic identities that we have learnt in previous classes. A cube minus b cube is nothing but a minus b into a square plus b square plus ab. This is a cube minus b cube. So let me use this here. Tan cube theta minus 1 can be written as tan theta minus 1 into tan square theta plus 1 plus tan theta divided by this tan theta into this tan theta minus 1. Now this gets cancelled, and dividing this by tan theta, I'll get tan square theta by tan theta will give me tan theta, 1 by tan theta will give me cot theta, and tan theta by tan theta will give me 1. But I need the answer in terms of secant and cosecant, okay? So let's convert it into secant and cosecant. How we will do that? I can write it as sine theta by cos theta, and this is cos theta by sine theta plus 1. This is very, very simple manipulation. You can do it yourself also, but let me show you. Now working on this expression, the LCM is sine theta cos theta, and here I will get sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 1. Now sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1 divided by sin theta cos theta plus 1. 1 by sin theta is cosecant theta, 1 by cos theta is secant theta. So this can be written as cosecant theta secant theta plus 1. This is the required expression. Right? There can be other ways of solving this question also. So you can try by starting with the converting into sine and cos directly. Right? That would also be a correct option. So I have tried to solve it using only tan theta, right? Okay, so let's move on to the next question here. Left hand side is 1 plus secant A by secant A, right? So if I divide both these terms by secant A, I'll get 1 by secant A plus 1, right? And 1 by secant A is nothing but cos A plus 1, okay? Now if I multiply and divide it by 1 minus cos A, what will happen is, this is 1 minus cos A, 1 plus cos A, so it will give me 1 minus cos square A divided by 1 minus cos A, and 1 minus cos square A is nothing but sin square A, and this is nothing but our right hand side, right? So hence proved. What I am doing is, I am just trying to create this right hand side out of this left hand side. So in most of the questions, you already know what the answer is, right? So looking at the answer, you need to decide your approach, right? Approaches can be different, but the answer would be same in mathematics, right? Here in this question, I required sin square A by 1 minus cos A, okay? So here I multiplied and divided by 1 minus cos A and I got my answer, right? So these questions are intuitive questions. If you have practiced a little bit in trigonometry, this answer will click itself. Okay, now we will use this identity here. Why I'm saying I'll use this identity? I can use this also. Cosecant square A minus cot square A is equal to 1. So I can write it as cosecant A minus cot A equal to 1 by cosecant A plus cot A, right? So I can use both these facts here. So what is my left hand side? Left hand side is equal to cos A minus sin A plus 1 divided by cos A plus sin A minus 1, right? Now, I know that I need to bring this expression into cosecant and cot, okay? So, let's first of all divide numerator and denominator. Divide numerator, this is numerator, and denominator by, I'll divide it by sin A, because if I divide cos A by sin A, it will give me cot A, and 1 by sin A will give me cosecant A. So let's divide numerator and denominator by sin A. So numerator will become cos A by sin A, cot A, sin A by sin A 1, 1 by sin A, cosecant A, divided by cos A by sin A, cot A, plus sin A by sin A 1 minus cosecant A. Now look at your requirement. You require cosecant A plus cot A on the right hand side. Right? And what are the manipulations that you can do? Let me club these two terms, cot A plus cosecant A minus 1 divided by cot A minus cosecant A plus 1, right? So I can write cosecant A minus cot A equal to 1 by cosecant A plus cot A. So what I can do here is, I can convert, let me write the numerator as it is. I can convert this term, cosecant A minus cot A equal to 1 by cosecant A plus cot A with negative sign, because this is cot A minus cosecant A. So with a negative sign, I can write 1 by cosecant A plus cot A and plus 1, right? So what will happen is cot A plus cosecant A minus 1 divided by, now this will become minus 1 plus cosecant A plus cot A divided by cosecant A plus cot A, right? So this expression and this expression is same, so I'll cancel it out, and cosecant a plus cot a will go in the numerator. Cosecant a plus cot a will come in the numerator, and this is your right hand side, so hence proved, right? Students, you can use multiple manipulations while solving a single question. You could have solved this question by other methods also. I found this method as the simplest method, so I solved it by using this identity, because it was already given in the question that you have to use this identity, right? So I used this identity to solve this question. You can do other manipulations, but you need to use this identity while solving this question, okay? Okay, let's look at this problem here. Left hand side says square root of 1 plus sin a divided by 1 minus sin a. Okay, now what I can do is I can multiply and divide this by 1 plus sin a by 1 minus sin a. I can multiply and divide by 1 plus sin a, right? Why I am doing it? Because the denominator in that case will become 1 minus sin square a, which is cos square a, right? So denominator will be rationalized, and in the similar manner numerator will become 1 plus sin a whole square, which will ultimately become 1 plus sin a. Now look at this, numerator has become 1 plus sin a whole square, right? And denominator has become 1 minus sin square a. So it can be written as 1 plus sin a divided by, this is nothing but cos square a, and cos square a square root is cos a. Okay, now you have got your answer. So the first term 1 by cos a is secant a, and second term sin a by cos a is tan a. Right, this was the answer that we were looking for. Okay, in this question also you can start with the right hand side and can go up to left hand side. So I would recommend that for practice you do it both ways. You start with left hand side and try to come to the right hand side, and then on the same notebook you do it by second method. You take the right hand side and then try to bring the left hand side out of it, right? So this will be very, very good for your practice. Okay, let's look at this question. We need to bring this expression in form of tan theta, right? So what I can directly see here is I can take sin theta as common from the numerator. So let me take sin theta common from the numerator. It will give me 1 minus 2 sin square theta, right? And if I take cos theta common from the denominator, it will be 2 cos square theta minus 1 inside the bracket. Now you already see that sin theta by cos theta is tan theta, so it will give me my answer. So these two brackets has to cancel out. So let's convert sin into cos or cos into sin, whichever way you want to do this question. So this can be written as tan theta, right? And let me write the denominator as it is, 2 cos square theta minus 1. And let me convert this sin square theta into cos square theta. So how do I do that? 1 minus 2. I can write sin square theta as 1 minus cos square theta, right? Using the first identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So I can write it as tan theta into, this will become 1 minus 2 plus cos square theta, 2 cos square theta divided by 2 cos square theta minus 1. So this is 1 minus 2 is nothing but minus 1. So tan theta, you can directly see the answer, right? 2 cos square theta minus 1. So this gets cancelled, hence your answer. right? Otherwise, one way of thinking about this can be, right? This is your method one. Otherwise, you can convert this expression here. You could have written, in place of this one, you could have written sine square theta plus cos square theta. Then what would happen is, this is nothing but tan theta. If I write sine square theta plus cos square theta in place of this one, right, minus 2 sine square theta, right, then 2 cos square theta minus 1. So, 1 sine square theta gets cancelled here. It will give me cos square theta minus sine square theta, and then again you have to convert sine square theta into cos square theta, right. So, both ways it is equivalent. So, you go by any of the methods. Now, what has happened is, it is cos square theta minus sine square theta divided by 2 cos square theta minus 1, right. Now, you can convert this 1 into sine square theta plus cos square theta, and the denominator will also become cos square theta minus sine square theta. Hence, you can cancel these two terms and your answer will be tan theta. So, other method was to convert this one into sine square theta plus cos square theta, and this one also in sine square theta plus cos square theta. Let's look at this one here. This looks pretty simple question. Let's first of all open these brackets. So, I can write it as sine square a plus cosecant square a plus 2 sine a cosecant a. 2 sine a cosecant a. Sine a cosecant a can be cancelled because these are reciprocals of each other. And let's open the second bracket. Cos square a plus secant square a plus 2 cos a into secant a. So, cos a and secant a will also get cancelled. So, this is my left hand side, right? So, this is the left hand side, right? Here I have written 2. Why? Because cos square a plus secant square a plus 2 into cos a secant a, right? A square plus b square plus 2ab, cos a and secant a got cancelled. So, I have written 2 here. Now, this 2 and this 2 will become 4 plus this sine square a and this cos square a will become sine square a plus cos square a. Right, here plus cosecant square a plus secant square a can be written, right. Now, this sine square a plus cos square a is equal to 1. So, 4 plus 1, this is equal to 5, right. And now, see the answer. You need tan and cot, but you have got cosecant and secant, which you can easily convert into tan and cot. How? 5 plus. This cosecant square a can be written as 1 plus cot square a by using the identity cosecant square a minus cot square a equal to 1. And this secant square a can be written as 1 plus tan square a by using the identity secant square a minus tan square a equal to 1. So, now, this 5 plus 1 plus 1 becomes 7 plus tan square a plus cot square a, which is equal to the right hand side. Hence, proved, right? Okay. Let us solve this question here. This says left hand side is equal to cosecant a minus sin a, secant a minus cos a, and we need to convert into tan a and cot a, this expression. So, cosecant a can be written as 1 by sin a minus sin a. This can be written as 1 by cos a minus cos a, okay. So, I can write it as 1 minus sin square a by sin a into 1 minus cos square a by cos a, which is equal to 1 minus sin square a can be written as cos square a by sin a into 1 minus cos square a can be written as sin square a by cos a, right? This 1 cos a gets cancelled, 1 sin a gets cancelled. So what I've got here is sin a into cos a. Now students, in the introduction I told you that every student knows sin square a plus cos square a equal to 1. But a few students, very few students will know that 1 is equal to sin square a plus cos square a, right? This knowledge is there, but where to use this knowledge? Let's use it here, sin a cos a by 1, right, to convert it into this one. So now I can write this 1 as sin square a plus cos square a. Now I can divide numerator and denominator by sin a cos a. So numerator will become 1, and when this denominator is divided by sin a cos a, this first term will become 10 a, and when this is divided by sin a cos a, this will become cot a, right, which is the required right hand side. How did I go from this step to this step? By dividing numerator and denominator by sin a into cos a, right? Okay, let's look at this question here. This is square, right? So we have to prove that this is equal to this equal to tan square a. So let's look at this expression here. This is very, very simple. 1 plus tan square a, and the denominator can be written as 1 by 1 plus 1 plus 1 by tan square a, right? Hence it can be written as 1 plus tan square a. This is this expression, right? So this can be written as tan square a plus 1 divided by tan square a. This will get cancelled, and this tan square a will come in the numerator, right? So this expression is equal to tan square a. Now let's look at the second one. 1 minus tan a by 1 minus cot a whole square. This can be written as 1 minus tan a divided by 1 minus 1 by tan a, right, whole squared. So this can be written as 1 minus tan a divided by tan a minus 1 by tan a whole square, right? Now I can cancel this 1 minus tan a and tan a minus 1 without changing the sign. Why? Because it is squared, right? 1 minus tan a and tan a minus 1 both are same. Otherwise, what you can do is, let's convert this expression into this, tan a into 1 minus tan a divided by 1 minus tan a, let us say with a negative sign. Ultimately, what would happen is, this negative sign will vanish because we are squaring this term. So these terms get cancelled, this negative sign will vanish, and tan a whole square is tan square a. So this is also proved to be equal to tan square a, hence this is proved, right?